Welcome back to Bhavna's Kitchen. Today I'm making very special recipe requested from many of you, and it is cream roll. It's time to enjoy the cream roll moment. I can't tell you, I have no words to say. It tastes so yummy. Just try once and you will make them again and again with different flavors. I'm making strawberry cream roll, but before I start making rolls, I would like to talk about my another hobby today with you all, which is blogging. If you have been watching my videos regularly, you must have noticed that I do post written recipes on my websites, and I have a couple of more websites where I post food topics regularly. And I thought of sharing about one of the company called Squarespace. Squarespace is an all-in-one platform that makes it fast, easy, and affordable to create professional-looking custom website. It aims to make the web a better place with better website. I am collaborating with a bunch of channels from around to twist this idea into a better web starts with your food. So make sure to check out end of my videos for many other awesome recipes. Squarespace is offering free trial, no credit card required. So I recommend to share your passion, whether it is cooking, crafting, art, anything that you would like to show to the world, it's your chance. Squarespace is offering 10% off for you guys as well. Just visit squarespace.com/food or click on the link provided under this video description and enter the code food at checkout. Now let's learn how to prepare cream roll. Preheat oven at 400 degrees Fahrenheit. Here I have this puff pastry. I'm just using the ready puff pastry, and I'm going to show you how to prepare rolls. Here I have prepared shapes using foil and wax paper, kind of a cylinder shape, and the cone shape. Here I have this wax paper and foil. Fold them in half and then simply just roll it. This is for making cylinder shape very easily. And then wrap wax paper roll with foil. So simply just roll. Your kids can do this job better. Now, in order to prepare cone, start from the middle. Just roll it like this. And now do the same again. Roll and finish rolling. Foil will help us to keep this in a place. There we got the cone. All right. And now, coming back to the puff pastry, I'm going to cut into stripes. Cut about 1 inch using pizza cutter. It makes a lot more easier. Start with one stripe. Just start from one end. Make sure to overlay a little bit. Here I have this baking tray. Make sure the end you keep at the bottom so that it doesn't open up again. Now let's make cone. Start from the bottom, dip. Again, make sure to overlay. Perfect, look at this. I would like to have these rolls a little bit nice golden brown color. So what I normally do, brush these rolls with water and then sprinkle granulated sugar. Oven is ready. And this tray is ready to go into the oven, preheated 400 degrees Fahrenheit, and bake for about 20 minutes or until you see nice golden brown color. While rolls are baking, I'm going to prepare cream. Here I have 1/4 cup of butter. To that, I'm going to add 1/2 cup of softened room temperature cream cheese. Make sure everything is softened, butter, cream cheese, about 2 tablespoons of powdered sugar, 1 teaspoon of pure vanilla extract. Now combine until nice and smooth, and it won't take too long because everything is nice and soft. All right, so you can see that it is nice and smooth. About 1/2 cup of Cool Whip cream. Once you add cream, fold in, do not over mix. And here I have strawberry jam, just about 1.5 tablespoon. Once you add even jam, don't stir too much. I just want kind of a swirl like this. And now here I have this piping bag and ready to stuff. All right, let's put this on the side right now. Rolls are looking nice golden brown color, and I'm ready to take it out. Look at this nice golden brown color. Let this roll cool down completely. I have already removed foil and wax paper from some of the roll. Just squeeze a little bit and then pull. Generously, just pull it. You don't want to press your roll, otherwise they break so easily. And now it's time to fill this roll. You can see that they're hollow inside. Fill, look at this. Put it on a serving plate. Here I have the cone. Perfect. And look at this plate. Here I got some strawberries. And here I got melted chocolate, which I'm going to drizzle on top. I made little cone. Just to simply drizzle on top like that. And now I got the white chocolate. And look at this beautiful plate. Oh yeah, from this beautiful plate, I thought of sharing one more thing about Squarespace is that they have a cool, sleek templates which you can use to spice up your website look. I'm impressed with Squarespace because they offer 24/7 support through email or chat. It comes with an online store. So you saw that preparing this recipe is pretty quick and easy and yet very inviting. And sharing your passion is also pretty easy. Thanks again to Squarespace for your support and for making the web a better place. And be sure to check out other videos as well.